Herko joins us. He's in for Dr. Kim this morning to answer your pet questions, and he's got his own little beautiful dog.
Yep, this is one of our own dogs. Her name is Maya, or Maya Papaya, as my daughter likes to call her. Little Shih Tzu Maltese mix that we got through one of the rescue groups, you know, try to cut down on some of the unwanted puppies that are out there, but very much a puppy and definitely not a forerunner in that, you know, ugly dog contest.
Are all the Shih Tzus this active? She's a cutie, or are they more relaxed as they get a little older?
It can be either way. Yeah. She's just a puppy, so she's, you know, hyper and going all the time is what it comes down to.
But a beautiful lap dog.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful.
When she sits still long enough.
Are they good with kids?
Oh, wonderful with kids. Yeah.
That's terrific. Okay, a couple questions here.
Sure.
Our 12-year-old Papillion is suffering from a bladder stone. She's eating a special diet, but still gets the stones. Other than surgery, what can be done about this?
There's a few different approaches you can use. Obviously, depending on the type of stone, diet is one of them. Mm-hmm. There are procedures if the stones are found small enough, a situation where you can try to flush the stones out. It's a little more involved than I can get to here, but it's something that you can certainly ask your regular vet about.
Would that be the surgery?
No, the surgical approach usually is making an incision and going in.
Yeah.
This is actually using a catheter to fill up the bladder and then trying to empty it out with the stones, trying to flush it out.
Yeah.
So a little less invasive for the puppy, per se.
But
that's something,
it still
requires a little anesthesia. So beyond the stone aspect, beyond the diet aspect, that's going to be the biggest way of trying to do it without doing anything anesthesia or surgery-wise. And that really depends on the type of stones you got.
So, chat with your vet. Determine what type of stone.
You can try to, with some of the testing, the urine testing, things like that, you can get an idea what the crystal types are that may give you an indication as to what type of stone it is.
Right, and how it could
exactly.
be broken up or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I hope that answers your question. Another one, is there an oral rabies vaccine available for dogs? My dog is terrified of shots.
There is an oral vaccine, but it's used mainly in wildlife.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's been approved for dogs yet. The good thing is they do have a 3-year, approved shot for rabies in puppies and cats now. So, for those ones that don't like shots, don't like going into the vets for it, we'd still recommend an annual vaccine to just examine the animal. But from the standpoint of the actual vaccine and the shots, it may just be something every 3 years that has to be given in that case.
When you have a dog that's reluctant to get the shot, I guess that's a nice way to put it.
Is there something
you can make to relax the dog a little
sure.
bit?
Sure. I mean, if we know that they're going to be that way ahead of time, you can talk with your vet, and there are, some sedatives or some, medications that can be done to relax them before they go in to see the vet.
All right. That's something to think about. Is it normal for a neutered male cat to try to mate with a neutered female cat? And how would I stop the behavior if there's no way to
That one's going to be a little more involved.
Offense?
barrier, separation, but no problem. The situation you're dealing with is, if it's a recent thing, you're going to have to keep them separate. If not, there are situations where you can work on some of the behavior aspects, but you can talk with your vet about that.
Okay. Mike, thanks for joining us this morning.
No problem.
You have a beautiful dog. Not in the ugly category.
Definitely not in the ugly category. Would not have won that one at all.
More coming up in just a few minutes.